zo cool, jongens. Mooier worden niet.
I'm Ramon. I was captain on this last 747-400 flight that came into Paramaribo today. This is very regretful. I've been here with the 747-300 years ago, 25 or 30 years ago. I came here as a captain on the MD-11, which disappeared in 2012. And then I went to the 747. And well, this was my last landing on the 747, and it was in Paramaribo. It's always a great experience to come here. We always have a lovely flight with 400 passengers. We're almost full every flight, and it's one big family that's flying. Everybody knows everybody. That makes it very cozy. It makes it very nice. For me, I will be returning here probably in a year or something on the 777 or the 787. Still, this ends. Big era since 1971. I've been flying with the 747. I've been lots of time in Paramaribo, and we get a great reception here, and it's always very nice with all the people in ground handling and the staff, and it feels like a second home. It feels like I lived in Amsterdam, and it feels like Amsterdam, but then in the tropics. So I very much like to come here. Unfortunately, due to the circumstances, we're not able to stay here. But for definite in the future years, I will come here and stay here and enjoy everything Suriname has to offer. Next step for me and for my colleagues is that we will be transferred to another aircraft type. For me, I will be probably captain on the 777-787. And we have to do a training in Amsterdam for that. That's taking several weeks on the flight simulator. And then we get some training for the routes that we fly. And the junior pilots, the co-pilots may transfer to co-pilot on the 777 or may go to captain 737 and become a captain of their own. It's going to take a few months to be on the next aircraft type. On the one hand, I'm excited to do so because it's a great job to do. But still, as I told before, it's really regrettable because I have to go to another aircraft. And I like the 747 as a big, huge aircraft. As a young boy, I liked the 747. So it's really painful to stop on the 747. So what will be the next and final step for this 747 is we'll embark the passengers. The crew will prepare themselves for a flight to Amsterdam. At this moment, there are some rain showers in the vicinity. So what we'll do is taxi out to the beginning of the runway. As you know, we have four engines. There's a lot of power, and in the flight probably will take 9 hours. So we don't need all the power to get off this runway of more than 3 kilometers. We go airborne at only a height of 500 feet, approximately 150, 200 meters high. We can set course left direct towards Amsterdam, and that's a straight ocean flight. So the next stop we'll see is the Azores, and then go to England. And then this aircraft will be its final landing in Amsterdam. And then the 747 will stop at KLM, unfortunately.